In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet simplifying radical expressions. Now, what we're going to do in order to simplify when we're looking at a number, in order to simplify a number within a radical, we need to find the largest perfect square that is a multiple of that number. So, for example, 125 is equal to 5 times 25, where 25 is that perfect square. And there's no other perfect square that can fit into 5, therefore our largest perfect square is 25. So we're going to write the square root of 125 in as the square root of 5 times 25 times n. So that's the square root of 5 times 25, which is 125, and then multiplying that by n. Now, 25 is perfect square because 5 squared equals 25. So 5 times 5 squared is 125. So again, I'll rewrite that square root, just breaking it down. We're going to have 5 times 5 squared times n. Now, I'm going to rearrange this square root, breaking up this 5 squared from underneath. So I'm going to have the square root of 5 squared, and I'm going to multiply that by the square root of 5n. Because I cannot simplify 5n any further within that radical, but the square root of 5 squared is simply 5, because the square root will cancel out that exponent of 2. So I'll have 5 times the square root of 5n as my solution in number 1. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, let's first look at that whole number of 216 and see what perfect square is a multiple of that. So we'll rewrite 216, finding that largest perfect square. Let's see if it's divisible by the first perfect square, which is 4, because we know, obviously, that it's divisible by 1. 216 is indeed divisible by 4. 216 equals 4 times 54. However, I believe there's a perfect square that goes into 54. So 4 times 54 equals 216. But if we're breaking up 54, 54 is not divisible by 4, so let's go to the next perfect square. 54 is indeed divisible by 9, and that's 9 times 6. Now I've rewritten 216 as 4 times 9 times 6, and there's no perfect square that's a multiple of 6. But there's a rule that says that a perfect square multiplied to another perfect square will always equal a perfect square. So if we multiply 4 by 9, we should get the largest perfect square that's in 216. So 4 times 9 is 36, and 36 times 6 equals 216. And 36 is 6 squared. So I'll rewrite 216 as the square root of 6 squared times 6, and then that's multiplied by v, so then I'll multiply that by v. So I'll rewrite this as the square root of 6 squared times the square root of 6v. And remember, the square root will cancel out that exponent of 2, therefore my answer is 6 times the square root of 6v in number 2. Now, again, for finding the largest perfect square that goes into 216, if you knew that 36 was at the start, you could skip these other steps that we did in order to find that number of 36. However, I was just showing you that you can write it out step by step in order to find that largest perfect square, as opposed to plugging in different numbers and using trial and error on your calculator. And again, that's because two perfect squares multiplied together will always equal a perfect square, and that was the largest perfect square within 216. Let's move on to number 3. And number 3, let's first look at 512. I'm going to rewrite 512 as, typing on my calculator, let's see if it's divisible by 4. 512 is indeed divisible by 4. That's 4 times 128. But let's rewrite 128. So that'll be 4 times 128 is also divisible by 4. So that's 4 times 4 times 32, since 128 is equal to 4 times 32. However, 32 has another perfect square that's a multiple. So we'll do 4 times 4 times 32 is also divisible by 4, and that's 4 times 8, and then 8 is divisible by 4, so that's 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 2. So multiplying my perfect squares together, 4 times 4 times 4 times 4, which is 4 to the 4th, that's 256 times 2 equals 512. So my largest perfect square in 512 is 256. And that just so happens to be 16 squared. 16 squared times 2 equals 512. So now I'll write this as the square root of 16 squared times 2, that's 512, and then I'll multiply that by k squared. Now note, this is the first case where my variable also has an exponent of 2. So I'm going to break up this square root as the square root of 16 squared times the square root of 2 times the square root of k squared. And I can split that up because all my terms are multiplied together. So now you'll see that the square root will cancel out that exponent of 2, so I'll be left with 16 times the square root of 2 times the square root will cancel out with that exponent of 2, so that's the variable k. So rewriting this, I'll have 16 times k times the square root of 2 as my solution in number 3. So 16k times the square root of 2. And quickly, I want to note that this square root cancels out that exponent of 2, because if you have any number, let's say x squared, taking the square root is the same as having x squared to the 1/2, because taking the square root of a number squared is the same as taking that number squared and then raising it to a power of 1/2, which from our rules of exponents or laws of exponents, that will be x, and then we'll multiply those exponents. 2 times 1/2 is 2 over 2, which is x to the 1st, which is simply x. So that's the reason why a square root cancels out an exponent of 2. Now, let's move on to number 4. In number 4, again, we have 512. However, we already wrote 512 in the previous problem. We figured out the perfect square that went into that, and that was 16 squared times 2. However, I'm also going to rewrite m to the 3rd. M to the 3rd, we can split this exponent up, remembering our rules of exponents, we can rewrite as m to the 2 plus 1, which is m squared times m to the 1st, or simply m. And remember that square root will cancel out that square. Therefore, for the square root of 512 times m to the 3rd, we'll have the square root of 16 squared times 2 times m squared times m to the 1st, or simply m. So now I'll break that up and have the square root of 16 squared times the square root of 2 times the square root of m squared times the square root of m. Which again, that square root will cancel out my exponents of 2. So I have 16 and m, so 16 times m times the square root of 2m, 2 times m, because there's 2 and an m still within that radical. So 16m times the square root of 2m is my solution in number 4. In number 5, I have the square root of 216 times k to the 4th. Now 216, we did in number 2, finding that largest perfect square, 216 equals 36 times 6, which is 6 squared times 6. So I'll have the square root of 6 squared times 6 for 216, and then I'm going to be multiplying that by k to the 4th. However, k to the 4th, I can write as two separate terms, k squared times k squared, because that's equal to k to the 2 plus 2, which equals k to the 4th. So I'll split this up as k squared times k squared. So I'll have the square root of 6 squared times the square root of 6 times the square root of k squared times the square root of k squared. My square roots will cancel out my exponents of 2. So I'll have 6 times k times k times the square root of 6. However, k times k is the same as k to the 1st times k to the 1st, which is k to the 1 plus 1, which we can write as 6k squared times the square root of 6. That's our solution in number 5. Continuing on to number 6, 100 is a perfect square. The square root of 100 is 10. So I'll rewrite this as 10 times the square root of v cubed. However, v cubed we can rewrite as v squared times v to the first. So when we rewrite v squared times v to the first, we'll have 10 times the square root of v squared times v. And remember that square root will cancel out that exponent of 2. So we'll be able to pull v out and we'll have 10v times the square root of v because that square root canceled out that exponent of 2. So if you need to, feel free to break this down again as 10 times the square root of v squared times the square root of v if you need to see each and every step. But I know now from practice that the square root of v squared will be v, and I'll just pull that out to get 10v times the square root of v. But feel free to continue to write it out and break up the square root until you feel comfortable. So again, our solution to number 6 is 10v times the square root of v. In number 7, we have 80p cubed. 80, a perfect square that goes into 80, is 4. 4 times 20. However, 4 times 20, I'll rewrite as 4 times 4 times 5. So 4 times 4, multiplying my perfect squares together, I'll get 16 times 5. So 16 is that perfect square that goes into 80. So rewriting 16 as that perfect square, I'll write 4 squared times 5. That's equivalent to 80. So the square root of 4 squared times 5 times p to the third, which p to the third is p squared times p, because we'll have p to the 2 plus 1, which equals p to the third. Simplifying, my square root will cancel out those exponents of 2, so I'll be able to pull out those bases. So I'll pull out 4 and p. So I'll have 4 times p times the square root of 5p. That's my solution in number 7. In number 8, we have the square root of 45 times p squared. 45 is 9 times 5. And 9 is that perfect square. 3 squared times 5 equals 45. So I'll write this as 3 squared times 5 times p squared. So I know that my square root will cancel out those exponents of 2, so the only number left within the radical will be 5. So I'll pull out my base of 3, and I'll pull out my p. So I'll have 3p times the square root of 5 for number 8. In number 9, now I'm working with 2 variables. However, again, let's start with that whole number. 147, I'll find a perfect square that goes into that. 147 is not divisible by 4, it's not divisible by 9, not divisible by 16, 25, or 36. However, it's divisible by 49, which is 7 squared. So 147 equals 49 times 3, which 49, as that perfect square, is 7 squared times 3. So I'll have the square root of 7 squared times 3 times m to the third, I'll write as m squared times m to the first, or simply m, and n to the third, I'll write as n squared times n to the first, because m to the 2 times m to the 1 is m to the 2 plus 1, which is m to the 3. Same with n. So now remember, my exponents of 2 will be canceled out with the square root, so I'll just have the bases, which will be 7, m, and n. And then within my radical, I'll still have 3, m, and n. So I'll have 7 times m times n times the square root of 3 times m times n. That is my solution in number 9. 7 times m times n times the square root of 3 times m times n. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 10. 200 we can write as 100 times 2, and 100 is that perfect square, so 200 is equal to 10 squared times 2. So I'll have the square root of 10 squared times 2, and m to the fourth we can write as m squared times m squared. However, we can also write m to the fourth as m to the 2 squared, because that would be equal to m to the 2 times 2, which is m to the 4th. So I'll rewrite m to the 4th as m squared squared. And then that gets multiplied to n. Now, remember, I'm going to pull out the bases that have an exponent of 2. So I'm going to be pulling out 10, and I'll be pulling out m squared, because the square root of m squared squared, that 2 will get canceled out, just as this 2 with the 10 will get canceled out. So I'll be pulling out 10 m squared, and within my radical, I'll still have 2 and n. So that's 10 times m squared times the square root of 2n. That's my solution in number 10. And again, that's because m squared, if we look at the square root of m squared squared, we're canceling out that exponent of 2 to give us m squared. Or, as we have been writing it, we've been writing it as m squared times m squared. That's equal to m to the 4th. However, once we take the square root of that, the square root will cancel out both of those 2s, so we will need to pull out 2 m's, so we'll pull out m times m, which is m squared. So either way you write m to the 4th, you will simplify it to get m squared. The square root of m to the 4th is m squared, which, another way to think of it, the square root of m to the 4th we can think of as m to the 4 to the 1 half, which is m to the 4 over 2, which equals m squared. So either way you think of m to the 4th, the square root of m to the 4th is m squared. Continue on to the next video, where I'll go over the next 10 problems. However, before you continue on, remember to click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your classmates.